get ready to match the star, Richard Deacon, Brett Summer, Nipsey Russell, Gunilla Hutton, Richard Dawson, and Mitzi McCall, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
Johnny Olson, thank you, friend, for joining us here. We're going to have a good time today. I don't care what they told you, Dad. What's wrong, Brett?
Can you see my lingerie straps?
No.
I'm not wearing any.
I said the same thing about her stockings, and she's not wearing any.
You know what?
What?
There was a thing in a magazine to see if you could go without a bra. You're supposed to put a pencil underneath your boobs. And if the pencils fall, you can go without a bra. And I did it, and one of the pencils fell and one of the pencils stayed. I really did.
You did.
Well, moving onward.
You did go without it, then.
Let him
so now I just wear a couple of erasers, right?
What do you say we say hello to our two players here, Janice, Larry, and Jack Steck. Hello there. How are you? Good. Janice Larry's our current champ. She's won $600. She's won one game and did pretty well with it. Are you ready to go on?
I'm ready.
All right, we found out a little bit about Jack Steck last time. You're from Texas, right?
From Dallas, right?
All right. Nice to have you with us, Jack. Good luck to you. We'll begin right after we pass along this message. Here we go. I push this button and reveal our first round questions and ask Jack, our challenger, to make a selection.
B, please.
New game, folks. Everybody plays. This is this. Tiny Tom Thumb said, my master gets a terrible headache every time I blank in his ear. Tiny Tom Thumb said, my master gets a terrible headache every time I blank in his ear.
I just want to know one thing.
What?
Now, is there an answer to that that I should be able to get to if I give it any thought, or is it just something?
No, well, there are a number of good possibilities there.
Okay.
Well, not a number of good possibilities.
Who
a number
is he
of.
Talking to?
Tiny Tom Thumb said, my master.
My master.
He's saying this to the world.
Mm.
He says, world, my master gets a terrible headache every time I blank in his ear. He was serious.
I've finished. Could I have the next question so I could.
Okay.
If I got ahead of
everybody. Yes, right. You could get ahead of everybody.
Well,
and go home early.
Yeah.
You're having trouble drawing a blank.
Yes.
Well, I can't
I am.
Help you.
I know.
And if the buzzer sounds.
I can't write blanks. So
you can't
okay.
write blank. Yet. My master gets a terrible headache every time I blank in his ear. Okay, that's it. All right, Jack Steck. Tiny Tom Thumb said my master gets a terrible headache every time I blank in his ear.
Scream.
Scream in his ear. Okay, Jack Steck. Richard Deacon.
Well. I said talk.
Talk, scream, not a match. Close, but no cigar.
Rats.
Brett? Rats, what?
Well, you know about all the passing strangers in my life, right?
Yep. Right.
Put me on the list.
Don't blow my joke.
Sorry.
I said blow in his ear.
Blow in his ear.
And I'll follow you anywhere.
That's right. That seems to be the answer, blow in his ear.
See, when you said Tiny Tom Thumb, I thought of a little guy about this side, and I thought maybe he was doing the boogaloo when he dances in his ear.
Dances in his ear. Okay, Gunilla.
Dum-dum here who drew the blank said yell.
Yell and scream is a match. There's one. That wasn't so dum-dum, Gunilla. That was very good. How about it? Mr. Whipsnade.
Larceny Whipsnade, yes. Well, I said I got a terrible headache every time the little rascal crawled.
Crawled in the ear.
In one ear and out the
other. In one ear and out the other. That hurt. The
master was a dumb.
What did you say, Mitzi?
I'm not making any excuses anymore. I said blow.
Okay. So you matched one celebrity there, Jack, and now let's see how Janice does with her first round question. Saturday night. In beautiful downtown Burbank, is so dull.
How dull is it, Gene?
Thank you. It's so dull that even the blanks fall asleep on the sidewalk. Thinking about that, Janice, Saturday night in beautiful downtown Burbank is so dull that even the blanks fall asleep on the sidewalks.
Why do you think I'm doing this?
Oh, you're the first. All right. Ready, ready, ready. Nipsey, are you writing?
I'm thinking, which is a longer process than writing for me.
Okay. Gunilla is just finishing her answer. And we're all set. So, Janice, Saturday night in beautiful downtown Burbank is so dull that even the blanks fall asleep on the sidewalks.
Hookers.
Will the first grade please tune out? Your first grade teacher.
Yes.
Yes. Okay, Janice. I heard what you said, Janice. What do you say, Richard?
Well, I didn't know how to spell the long version, so I put streetwalkers.
Oh. Well, yes, Brett.
What grade did you say she taught?
She's a first grade teacher.
My kid goes to a very progressive school. But not where she teaches. If anyone's gonna teach him anything, it's gonna be me.
Oh.
And I have. Now, rug makers or hookers?
Oh, rug makers. People who make rugs, eh, Nipsey?
The young females referred to by that rude term are really social workers for the rich. I put the same thing. Ladies of the evening.
Ladies of the evening. Wasn't there a song called Ladies of the Evening?
I don't know it.
Would you sing it?
I can't sing it if
yes,
I don't
you can
know
sing it.
No,
if I tell
I
you to sing
I
it. Oh, all right,
no,
you can't sing it.
I think Nipsey and I went to the same school.
Oh, really? Yeah. Why?
Because we both put it the same way. Ladies of the Evening.
All right, there's another one for you, Janice. You're up to four. I must say, the hookers are doing very well, Richard. What,
yes.
What have you got there?
Make a rug for me.
Speaking as a hooky.
You mean you're not going to contribute?
Well, she is such a lovely lady.
She's a sweet, dignified,
charming
lady.
Mind you, in about 18 years, some of her kids are going to be so happy.
Yeah.
No, I said the muggers.
The muggers, yeah. Saturday night, beautiful downtown Burbank, so dull even the muggers fall asleep on the sidewalk. She says hookers. What do you say?
You may not understand this. I put ants, but I have an aunt who's a hooker.
No.
I'll give her a lump of sugar.
Give her a lump of sugar. That's it. All right. 4-1 the score. Round one is finished. Round two coming up in a moment or so. But right now, we have this for you. Here we go. I'll push this button, I guess. Oh, yeah. See, it works. Nice. Jack, what do you say?
I'll try B again.
B again. Here we go. Last time you matched one person. Who was that? Gunilla. You're the only one who does not play. You lay out.
Oh, that's right. All I right. did match him, didn't I?
That was Farmer Brown's chicken. Is so stupid.
How stupid is he?
I'll tell you how stupid that chicken is. That chicken is so stupid, Farmer Brown had to teach it how to blink.
Oh, I got it this time.
Very good.
Good. That chicken is so stupid, Farmer Brown had to teach it how to
blink. Don't steal my answer.
You hear that, Jack? Think about it. Are you thinking about it, Jack?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Ever been on a farm, Jack?
Yeah.
You have? Well, then you know about chickens.
That's right.
All right.
You know about chickens, Jack.
Nipsey's the only one who's not ready.
I'm ready. I just don't have the answer ready.
All right. Now he's ready. So, Jack Steak, it's up to you. Farmer Brown's chicken is so stupid, Farmer Brown had to teach it how to...
lay.
How to lay. Okay. All right. That's what he said. Richard, what do you say?
Lay eggs.
Lay. Okay. All right. There's one for you, Brett.
Did you know that Dallas and Fort Worth were twin cities?
That's right.
And you know that my children's godmother is a McLean from Fort Worth?
Well, no.
Yes.
What else would you like to talk about?
And I said to help this poor man along in life because I have a certain loyalty to Texas. Lay eggs.
There it is. There's another one. That's two for you, Jack. Score is now 3-4. What
I
do you say?
I thought even a dumb chicken would know how to lay. I said teach her how to cluck.
Cluck.
Okay. So, Richard.
Yes, I also went with the cluckers.
Right.
Okay. You gotta match Mitzi to stay in the game, Jack. Let's see if you do it, Mitzi.
What do you think, group?
Yeah.
I did it!
Yeah. Yay! Now, at this moment, we have a tie 4-4. Janice, you got to match one celebrity to win the game. This is your assignment. The pilot said to the co-pilot, "Don't tell this to anyone, but I blank before every flight." Pilot. Oh, just two of you play. Right.
Can I tell you how thrilled I am I don't have to answer that?
What?
I'm so thrilled I don't have to answer that.
That's an easy one. The pilot said to the co-pilot, "Don't tell this to anyone, but I blank before every flight." They're all finished. And Janice, have you thought about it? "Don't tell this to anyone, but I blank before every flight." Pilot speaking to the co-pilot.
Drink.
Drink. Drink. Okay. She says this pilot drinks before every flight. What do you say to that? Oh. Oh. Oh! Drink wins the game. What have you got? I'll be down. Come on down, Janice. Very good. Where are you? So you've got another 100 standby. Sorry to see you go, Jack. Have a nice trip back to Dallas. And thank you for coming up here. We've got a gift for you.
Thank you.
Jack Step, ladies and gentlemen. Janice, you got $700. Here you go again for the big money. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. We polled a recent studio audience. Are you ready in there? I hear all the shuffling of feet. What's going on? Okay, he's ready.
So right.
All right. We polled a recent studio audience. We got their best response to this. Boot blank. The answer they gave most often is worth $500. Then if you match the next one, you get $250. If you match a bottom one, you get $100. From whom would you like some help?
Richard?
Boot.
Oh, Boot Hill.
Boot Hill.
Where a lot of cowboys went to die.
Boot Hill, eh?
If you don't like it now, you know what you can do with it.
Boot Hill is
first
his
thing
answer.
Came to my mind.
Yes, all right.
Nipsey,
what have you got?
Well, my home, Atlanta, they refer to the fellow who shines shoes as a boot black.
God boot black. Boot black. Okay, there are two boys.
Brent.
Well, honey, I have the best one this time.
What?
Boot camp.
Boot camp. That's a Marine Corps place. Yeah, boot camp, boot black, and boot hill. You can choose one of those, or if you want to reject them all and give us one of your own, it's up to you. Janice, we call for an answer now.
Hill.
Boot Hill. Boot Hill is the answer you want. Okay. All right, Boot Hill is what she's looking for. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. May we see the $100 response? Boot Camp. That's the one. Who gave you that one? Brett gave you that one.
Well, maybe that
okay.
is going to be Boot Hill.
Still looking for Boot Hill. Here is the $250 response. Boot Hill is up there. Yeah, the boy. All right. Yeah. That's two, right? What's his name?
Maurice.
Two. That's two, Maurice. Yeah. Should I go down there and kiss him?
Humor.
No. All right. What do you think is under the $500?
Bootleg.
Bootleg is what the audience says. Here it is. Bootlegger.
And I hope.
Yeah.
I hope you notice how they groaned when I said Boot Hill.
Yeah. I tell you, I'll be a little.
You didn't think it was, did you?
I groaned too. I was groaning with the audience.
That's right.
There.
You had to have $250 to get there.
What does Boot Hill mean?
Oh, that's a place where people are buried.
In Dodge
that's
City.
You're there with the boots on and they bury you there.
In Boot Hill.
Okay. Are you an American?
Yes, I am.
Do you have any identification?
Yes, I do. My first papers, at
that's
least.
Just Dodge City is Boot Hill.
Well, I'm not a member of this Hollywood community where all of you people have watched cowboy movies all day long. I've got other things to do with my life.
Take
you
your
don't like show business.
Yeah.
Shall we get on with it?
Yes.
Would you like to dismiss this bunch and get another one? Now, listen, you're going to play for $2,500 now, but you have to match one celebrity before we can give you the money. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Richard. Okay. Here we go for the $2,500, Richard. Blank party. Or blank party. All right, he's finished. Now, Janice, we need a response from you, which you think will match his answer. Blank party or blank party. What do you say to that?
House
party. She says house party, and the audience is groaning. All right, Richard, for $2,500, may we see your answer?
Birthday party.
You know, I didn't think of it, but now that he holds it up, it seems like such an obvious thing, doesn't it?
It does.
Well, okay. Well, listen, Janice, you've got $950, and that ain't bad. Is that bad?
No.
No. Okay. All right, here is something that's really good for you. Pay attention to this. Now we're ready to play another game. You ready? Okay, then let's present another player. We're a great deal of pleasure. We present Sarah Lopez. How are you, Sarah?
Hi.
You know Janice, don't you? Please tell us a little bit about yourself, Sarah.
I'm a housewife. I live in Lompoc, California, and I have two beautiful little girls, Tiffany 4 and Joreen 2. And I'm nervous, and I have a backyard full of animals.
Really? What kind, for instance?
I have
dogs and cats?
Three cats, one dog, turkey, three ducks, two geese, chickens, and do they all get along?
They like each other?
No. We keep them separate.
You keep them separate, yeah. Are there two of each?
Yes, of course.
Oh, really? That's nice. Have you built the ark yet?
No.
All right. Take your animals two by two. All right, Sarah, as a challenger, would you make a selection?
B, please.
All right, here we go. Got a new game going here, folks. Dumb Dora was so dumb.
How dumb was she?
She was so dumb that she tried to clean the blank with a vacuum cleaner. That's how dumb she was. Dumb Dora was so dumb she tried to clean the blank with a vacuum cleaner. Think about that, Sarah.
I think there's a lot of Betty White.
Go ahead
now.
Okay.
1 second.
Come on, Nipsey.
Running late. Okay.
Now, Sarah, it's up to you. Dumb Dora was so dumb, she tried to clean the blank with a vacuum cleaner.
Refrigerator?
I want my old answer back.
Sarah, I don't think she was that dumb. We're going to find out how dumb she is right now. Richard?
This will be a good chance for the audience to release their hostilities and be my guest when I said bathtub.
No, you see, they think that's the idea is...
Not you, sir, just the rest of the people. He turns into a mob just by himself.
Well, that's not a bad answer, I think. Brett, what do you say? Refrigerator is the answer that Sarah's looking for.
I say, what's the name of this show?
How dumb was Dumb Dora?
Dumb Dora was so dumb, she tried to clean her toilet bowl with the bath. The popular fave.
Yeah, popular favorite. Nipsey, how dumb was she?
I felt embarrassed until I realized I'm part of the majority here.
That's it. That seems to be the answer, Sarah. What do you say, sweet, demure little lady?
Well, I think we all know what dumb is, and that's toilet.
Okay. All right, what do you say, sweet, demure young man?
I'm just shocked at their language. I said toilet.
Yes, he's shocked. Mitzi?
Here's a winner.
Here's a winner.
I ought to know better than anyone, because I'm the dumbest one. She's trying to clean her bird cage with
a bird cage. Really dumb. And I don't mean Dumb Dora. Oh, would you like to have... What do you want to do? You want to do the commercial or you want to do another question? You want to do the commercial. Anything you say, you're paying the bills. What the heck do I care? Hold on here. Stand by, folks. We got a little message for you. Bing. Go. I get so taken up with things here, I forget that it's the end of the show. But it is the end, right, Pat?
Right.
So, I'm sorry. You know, time flies when you're having fun, doesn't it? It's the end. We'll see you next time. Where are we? We're in the middle of round one, and you didn't score with yours, and yours is coming up. Okay. Now, I forgot to mention that Richard Deacon has a book out. What's it called?
Richard Deacon's Microwave Oven Cookbook.
and I have a copy of it. Oh,
you have terrific. A copy.
And so do I.
You, oh, yes.
It's a drama.
It's a drama.
Yes. Microwave oven. Followed some of the recipes.
Do you know that you can make eggs Benedict in 3 minutes, right?
Terrific.
Isn't that fabulous?
Yes.
If you I only had
Andy a... Donald in 2 minutes.
Mitzi, would you... We've got a few seconds here. I think we'd like to hear a poem from you.
A poem on credit.
On credit, yes.
If you owe too much on your American Express and your Diners Club bill is too large, take a loan on your Bank AmeriCard and pay it off with your Master Charge.
Well, friends, and that's why this country is in such terrific economic problems today because of that. Gene Rayburn, Match Game 74. Join us next time. Goodbye.
Stay tuned for Tattle Tales next over most of these CBS stations. Get ready to match the star, Richard Deacon, Brett Summer, Nipsey Russell, Gunilla Hutton, Richard Dawson, and Mitzi McCall as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
Johnny Olson, thank you, friends, for joining us here. We're going to have a good time today.
I don't care what they told you, darling. What's wrong, Brett?
Can you see my lingerie straps?
No.
I'm not wearing any.
I said the same thing about her stockings, and she's not wearing any.
You know what?
What?
There was a thing in a magazine to see if you could go without a bra. You're supposed to put a pencil underneath your boobs. And if the pencils fall, you can go without a bra. And I did it, and one of the pencils fell and one of the pencils stayed. I really did.
You did.
Well, moving onward.
You did go without it, then.
Let him so now it. I just wear a couple of erasers, right?
What do you say we say hello to our two players here, Janice Larry and Jack Steck. Hello there. How are you? Good. Janice Larry's our current champ. She's won $600. She's won one game and did pretty well with it. Are you ready to go on?
I'm ready.
All right, we found out a little bit about Jack Steck last time. You're from Texas, right?
From Dallas, right?
All right. Nice to have you with us, Jack. Good luck to you. We'll begin right after we pass along this message. Here we go. I push this button and reveal our first round questions and ask Jack, our challenger, to make a selection.
B, please.
New game, folks. Everybody plays. This is this. Tiny Tom Thumb. Well,
yes, Brett.
What grade did you say she taught?
She's a first grade teacher.
My kid goes to a very progressive school, but not where she teaches. If anyone's going to teach him anything, it's going to be me.
Oh.
And I have. Now, rug makers or hookers?
Oh, rug makers. People who make rugs, eh, Nipsey?
The young females referred to by that rude term are really social workers for the rich. I put the same thing. Ladies of the evening.
Ladies of the evening. Wasn't there a song called Ladies of the Evening?
I don't know it.
Would you sing it?
I can't sing it if
yes,
I don't
you
know
can
it.
Sing it. No, if I tell you to sing it.
Can't.
Oh, all right,
but
you can't sing it.
I think Nipsey and I went to the same school.
Oh, really? Yeah. Why?
Because we both put it the same way. Ladies of the evening.
All right, there's another one for you, Janice. You're up to four. I must say, the hookers are doing very well, Richard. What,
yes,
what have you got there?
Make a rug for me.
Speaking as a hookie.
You mean you're not going to contribute?
Well, she is such a lovely lady.
She's a sweet, dignified,
charming
lady.
Mind you, in about 18 years, some of her kids are going to be so happy.
Yes.
No, I said the muggers.
The muggers,
yes. I did laugh.
Saturday night, Burbank. Beautiful downtown Burbank, so dull even the muggers fall asleep on the sidewalk. She says hookers. What do you say?
You may not understand this. I put
aunts, but I have an aunt who's a hooker.
I'll give her a lump of sugar.
Give her a lump of sugar. That's it. All right. 4-1 the score. Round one is finished. Round two coming up in a moment or so. But right now, we have this for you. Here we go. I'll push this button, I guess. Oh, yes. Said, my master gets a terrible headache every time I blank in his ear. Tiny Tom Thumb said, my master gets a terrible headache every time I blank in his ear.
I just want to know one thing.
What?
Now, is there an answer to that that I should be able to get to if I give it any thought, or is it just something?
No, well, there are a number of good possibilities there.
Okay.
Well, not a number of good possibilities. Tiny Tom Thumb said, my master. He's saying this to the world.
Mm.
He says, world, my master. That's a terrible headache every time I blank in his ear. He was serious.
I've finished. Could I have the next question so I could...
Okay.
If I got ahead of
everybody. Yes, right. You could get ahead of everybody and go home early.
Yeah.
You're having trouble drawing a blank?
Yes,
well, I can't help you.
I know.
And if the buzzer sounds...
I can't write blanks, so
you can't write blank yet. My master gets a terrible headache every time I blank in his ear. Okay, that's it. All right, Jack Stick. Tiny Tom Thumb said my master gets a terrible headache every time I blank in his ear.
Scream
in his ear. Okay, Jack Stick. Richard Deacon.
Well, I said talk.
Talk, scream, not a match. Close, but no cigar.
Rats.
Brett? Rats, what?
Well, you know about all the passing strangers in my life, right?
Yep, right.
Put me on the list.
Don't blow my joke.
Sorry.
I said blow in his ear.
Blow in his ear.
And I'll follow you anywhere.
That's right. That seems to be the answer, blow in his ear.
See, when you said Tiny Tom Thumb, I thought of a little guy about this side, and I thought maybe he was doing the boogaloo when he dances in his ear.
Dances in his ear. Okay, Gunilla.
Dum-dum here, who drew the blank, said yell.
Yell and scream is a match. There's one. That wasn't so dum-dum, Gunilla. That was very good. How about it, Mr. Whipsnade?
What, you make your change, did you? Larceny Whipsnade, yes. Well, I said I got a terrible headache every time the little rascal crawled
in the ear.
In one ear and out
in one ear and out the other. That hurt. The
master was a dumb
What do you say, Mitzi?
I'm not making any excuses anymore. I said blow.
Okay. So you matched one celebrity there, Jack, and now let's see how Janice does with her first round question. Saturday night in beautiful downtown Burbank is so dull.
How dull is it, Gene?
Thank you. It's so dull that even the blanks fall asleep on the sidewalk. Thinking about that, Janice, Saturday night in beautiful downtown Burbank is so dull that even the blanks fall asleep on the sidewalks.
Why do you think I'm doing this?
Oh, you're the first. All right. Ready. Nipsey, are you writing?
I'm thinking, which is a longer process than writing for me.
Okay. Gunilla is just finishing her answer. And we're all set. So, Janice, Saturday night in beautiful downtown Burbank is so dull that even the blanks fall asleep on the sidewalks.
Hookers?
Will the first grade please tune out? Your first grade teacher.
Yes.
Okay, Janice. I heard what you said, Janice. What do you say, Richard?
Well, I didn't know how to spell the long version, so I put streetwalker.
Oh. Works, nice. Jack, what do you say?
I'll try B again.
B again. Here we go. Last time you matched one person. Who was that? Gunilla. You're the only one who does not play. You lay out.
Oh, that's right. All right. I did match him, didn't I?
That was Farmer Brown's chicken. Is so stupid.
How stupid is he?
I'll tell you how stupid that chicken is. That chicken is so stupid, Farmer Brown had to teach it how to blink.
time.
Very good. That chicken is so stupid, Farmer Brown had to teach it how to bite.
Don't steal my answer.
You hear that, Jack? Think about it. Are you thinking about it, Jack?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Ever been on a farm, Jack?
Yeah.
You have? Well, then you know about chickens.
That's right.
All right. You know
about chickens, Jack.
Nipsey's the only one who's not ready.
I'm ready. I just don't have the answer ready.
All right, now he's ready. So, Jack Steak, it's up to you. Farmer Brown's chicken is so stupid, Farmer Brown had to teach it how to...
lay.
How to lay. Okay. All right. That's what he said. Richard, what do you say?
Lay eggs.
Lay. Okay. All right, there's one for you, Brett.
Did you know that Dallas and Fort Worth were twin cities?
That's right.
And you know that my children's godmother is a McLean from Fort Worth?
Well, no.
Yes.
What else would you like to talk about?
And I said to help this poor man along in life because I have a certain loyalty to Texas. Lay eggs.
There it is. There's another one. That's two for you, Jack. Scores now 3-4. What do you say?
I thought even a dumb chicken would know how to lay. I said teach her how to cluck.
Cluck.
Okay. So, Richard.
Yes, I also went with the cluckers.
Right.
Okay. You got to match Mitzi to stay in the game, Jack. Let's see if you do it. Mitzi?
What do you think, group?
Yeah.
I did it!
Yeah. Yay! Now, at this moment, we have a tie 4-5.